So yeah, welcome to testing CamelK integrations with Cloud Native BDD. So a few words to my person. My name is Christoph Deppisch. I'm working as a software engineer for Red Hat. And basically, most of the time, I'm working on the middleware integration section with Camel. And test automation has been a personal interest of myself since ages, I would say. So I'm also the founder of the Citrus framework. So we will see this later on. This is a test framework. And yeah, test automation has been a very strong belief of myself. So I'm very convinced about test automation that helps you to deliver the right quality of software. So today, I want to talk about a short introduction about Apache CamelK. So I think you may have heard of it the last 2 days. But to be on the same page, I will introduction to it and also with behavior-driven development for those who haven't been working with this before, so we know about the concepts here. Then I go on to say, why do we need Cloud Native BDD? And then the framework YARN, which will be the implementation of these concepts. And then we hopefully have a quite cool demo where you can see this in action. And then the status and the future work. So Apache CamelK, as this is the Apache Camel integration track at this ApacheCon, you may have heard of this before. So CamelK is a lightweight integration platform born on Kubernetes with serverless superpowers. So it is a sub-project of Apache Camel. And I think and I assume that most of you have heard of Apache Camel before. So it is the Swiss knife of integration, has a lot of components to integrate with different messaging transports, data formats, technologies, and is one of the most active Apache projects. So CamelK is a sub-project out of this. It was born out of Camel, and it started in August 2018, reached version 1.0 this year. And as I said, it's a platform for directly running integrations written in Camel on an OpenShift or Kubernetes cluster and leverages the operator SDK. So we have an operator that takes care of our integrations and runs those on the OpenShift cluster. So why do we need integration? So I said Camel is the Swiss knife of integration. So if you develop your application, it doesn't really matter which technology you are using or which language you are writing your application in. Nowadays, you are not alone in the world. So most of the time, and this is pretty sure, you have to integrate with others, other services, other applications, other software components in order to build a certain business logic. And this is where integration comes in, because your application might be using REST technology, another application might use Kafka or event streaming technology, and you have to integrate with each other to exchange data and to form a business logic. So this is where Camel comes in. So let's have a look at this very simple example. So in the middle, this app is developed by you. It's using Knative, obviously, and gets data from an Apache Pulsar application, and it pushes data to a Kafka topic. And this is where Camel comes in. So everywhere where you have this integration boundaries to different technologies or different messaging transports, you can use Camel and CamelK. And you may have seen this a lot of times in the last 2 days, this Camel domain-specific language where you can say from Pulsar to Knative or from Knative to Kafka, and everything that's highlighted here is one of those 340 plus components that Apache Camel provides so you can use all these technologies and integrate. So this is the basic overview why we use CAML in integration. So CAML-K is then taking this into the cloud infrastructure. So you write this integration with the normal CAML domain-specific language. You can use Java, Kotlin, Groovy, and you write this integration file and you simply execute this with a CAML run integration.java. And this takes this to the operator, the CAML-K operator, and this is taking everything else to let your integration be running on OpenShift or Kubernetes. So this is the basic architecture and idea. So about half a year ago, we asked ourselves, how can I test CAML-K integrations? And thought of something that must be something of integration testing, because as you saw, we just write this integration file, we use the CAML DSL, we execute it with the command line tool, and then it's running in the cluster. So there's not a lot of places where you can have unit testing or very fine granular testing. You have to invoke the CAML-K integration with real messages, and on the other side verify the outcome of the integration with a real message interaction. So this is what we were searching for. And this is where behavior-driven development comes in. So for those who haven't been working with this before, so behavior-driven development is about communication. So you have different kind of personas in your company. You have the domain experts. You have those people that really know how the business logic should look like. The domain experts know exactly where and when to put data. And on the other hand, you have the technical staff like developers and testers and so on, and operations. And these people need to communicate with each other. And things can go very, very deeply wrong when this communication between those different kind of personas is not working. So behavior-driven development tries to give concepts and tools to improve this communication. And it's all about explaining the behavior. So when you explain a quite complex scenario to another person, it's a good idea to give a very concrete example. And this concrete example examines the whole logic and the whole explanation that you are doing quite well to the other person. So this has been proven to be very effective when it comes to describing business logic and complex scenarios to another person, and it improves the communication between people. So giving concrete examples. And this is where Gherkin comes in. So Gherkin is a language or syntax that gives us some keywords, like given a certain context, when some event happens, then an outcome should occur. And this given when then syntax in combination with having concrete examples has been proven to be very effective to describe behavior, to describe logic, and people from different backgrounds can read those features and can read those Gherkin syntax and understand what's going on. So this is the idea behind behavior-driven development. And why did we choose behavior-driven development for our way to test CAML-K integrations? Because it's actually the same as you do with CAML-K. You write a feature file, you use this Gherkin syntax with given when then, and you take this feature file and execute it with a command line tool. Here it is called YAX test integration.feature. And then an operator on the Kubernetes or OpenShift cluster takes over and executes this feature as a test. So it's pretty much exactly the same architecture and the same idea as in CAML-K. Why behavior-driven development was so good for us. So why do I have to execute my tests in the cloud-native infrastructure? Why do we need cloud-native testing? So when you run your tests as part of the container managed platform, you gain a lot of benefits from it. So the first one is the tests are integrated into the cloud infrastructure, so they can access internal services also. So maybe there's a service that is not exposed to the outside of the cluster, or It is a Kafka broker which is not exposed to the outside. The test should be able to access those internal services to verify the outcome and to invoke services that are internal. And when the tests are running inside the cloud infrastructure, you are able to do that. The next thing is simulating services. So imagine your CamelK integration talks to another service, but this other service is developed by a total different team, has a total different release lifecycle. Maybe it's not even started to be implemented yet, but you need the service in order to verify your own service. So you need to simulate services, and this is very easy if the test is running inside the cloud infrastructure. So then the test can also make use of service allocation and service providing in order to simulate things. And last not least, the tests are self-contained. So when the test starts up, it can maybe start in Knative eventing source. It can start up a Kafka messaging broker. It can really self-contained prepare all this infrastructure that is needed to run the test. So the test can do this when it's running on the cloud infrastructure itself. So you can think of it as there's a club in town. It's called OpenShift on Kubernetes, and all the cool technologies are already in there on the dance floor having fun. So we have CamelK, we have Postgres, Quarkus, Knative, and all the cool technologies. And there's this angry security doorman that doesn't allow testing tools to take part. And testing tools are left outside, and they cannot really take part of the internal of the club. And with the framework that we provide, you get entrance onto the dance floor, and you can really have fun and integrate with all those technologies running on cloud native infrastructure. So this framework is called YAX, and YAX is a testing framework that enables cloud native BDD testing on Kubernetes. It was born out of CamelK, but we soon realized that this is not only for testing CamelK integrations, but this is for any service that runs on a Kubernetes or OpenShift environment. So anything that runs inside of this cloud container management platform can be tested with YAX. And the current version is 0.1.0. It is not released yet, but it will be released soon within the next few days, I guess. So behind the scenes, YAX is using two other frameworks you may have heard of. It's the one is called Cucumber. So Cucumber is the BDD feature framework that executes feature files as Java unit tests. So it takes a feature file written in Gherkin and makes it executable as a Java unit test. And it has first-class support in IDEs. So you have syntax highlighting and auto-completion for all the feature files. Citrus is the next tool that is used behind the scenes. So this is a framework that enables message integration testing. So it has powerful validation mechanisms for JSON payloads, XML payloads, plain text payloads, and it can connect to different messaging transports such as HTTP REST, Kafka, JMS, Knative, all that stuff that we need in order to verify a running integration in the Kubernetes cluster. And these two are open source by Apache license. So have a look at a sample test in YAX. So this is a normal BDD feature file where we use this given when then syntax, and it's each line in this feature file is translated with Cucumber into executable Java code. And this is also something that YAX as a framework provides. So each line here you can use out of the box, and you don't have to implement the underlying logic to send out an HTTP request or to push a event to an event streaming on Kafka. Everything that you see here is already implemented, and you can just write this feature file and execute this as a test. And As I said, the behavior-driven development concepts should be readable for everybody. So you have a very readable test at the very end where you can say, given waiting for an URL to return 200 okay, and this is a health check, for example, you can also make use of a JSON payload. So you can file a request in HTTP, use this JSON payload with variable support. We can make use of Citrus functions in here. And of course, the response is then validated. Here it is validated that the response is a HTTP 201 created. And of course, you can also have this powerful JSON validation. I mentioned it from Citrus. So here we get a to-do task. It is a JSON payload, and we can expect this JSON payload in here in the test. And then the powerful validation mechanism takes in where JSON payloads are compared, and you can ignore subtrees and you can make use of variables and validation matches. So this is pretty powerful and all that we need to verify messaging, and we are dealing with messaging here. And all that you can, all you have to do is to say YAX test and use this feature file, and then you have a running test. And let's have a quick look on the timeline. Okay, I have some time left. So the YAX architecture, as I said, it's pretty much the same as CamelK. You have a command line tool where you can execute the feature files and the tests. We saw this before. You can say YAX test and then provide the feature file. And you can install the operator into your cluster. So we have a YAX operator that is running and watching out for custom resources of type test. And when the CLI puts in or generates such a custom resource, then the operator takes over, prepares the runtime for the test, and executes the test as a side of the cluster. So we have a pod running here. It's using a Java runtime with Maven. So you can reference external artifacts from a Maven registry. But as I said, YAX offers a lot of modules that are out of the box, usable without writing any Java code or any other code in order to connect to HTTP REST endpoints, to send messages to JMS, to push events on a Kafka topic or Knative eventing. And these modules are already there. You can use those in the feature file. And these are all translated into executable Java code. And then, of course, you have this other system under test running in the platform on the platform. And this is then invoked with real messaging. Real messages are sent over the wire, connecting HTTP REST endpoints and verifying the responses. And also, you can mix all the technologies, so you can write a test where you first of all send an HTTP request, then as a second step, you receive a Kafka message on a Kafka topic, then you publish a Knative event, and all that stuff can be mixed in one test. So this is the basic architecture, and now we want to see this in action. I have prepared a small demo here, so we have a CamelK integration, which is called a greeting service. And this greeting service has a nice set of greetings in different languages. So we have English, German, French, Italian, and Spanish. And yeah, feature files or clients can create new greetings, can get all the greetings, a simple REST service where you can have different operations, get, delete, post, put, whatever. And this is nothing fancy in here, but the example goes a little bit further. The greeting service, when you say HTTP post on a resource, and this is the language that we want to use, will instruct the greeting service to publish a new message on a Kafka topic. So we were choosing here the English language. So then a new message in English language, a greeting message will be pushed to this topic, greetings. And then later on, we will connect this topic to another CamelK integration, which uses the Splitter enterprise integration pattern. So then the greeting message is split into its words using the space as a delimiter. So then we will have multiple messages in the topic, which should be words here. This is an error. It should be the topic words, not greetings. But as you can see, it is pushed into another topic, and then hopefully we will be able to receive this topic event and have it in our feature file once again. So this is the overall sample that we want to have in this little demo. So let me switch to IntelliJ. So hopefully you can see this now. So in here, this is my little Yux demo application. So this is the greeting service that I was talking about. It is providing a open API REST service. It's really, really easy. So it has this in-memory greetings store where we have this different languages and the greeting messages. And we have different operations here like get, post, put, delete, and some health check also. And this is also already running on my cluster. So if I go in here and show you the topology view, you can see here, this is my greeting service. It's already running. I can also invoke this get request here. So I get a list of all the languages that are available. And I can also get one language here. So I see the message here in English, maybe Italian. Do we have Italian people on the call? So this is then saying ciao. Maybe I can make it a little bit bigger. And of course, you have this open API specification. This is a normal open API 3 specification that is provided with the REST service. And now we want to go ahead and start testing this as a client. So let's go to the test that I have prepared. So this is the greeting service test. It is basically what we have seen before in the sample. We give an URL, and this is the URL of my service within the cluster. I can make a health check and wait for a GET request on the path health and validate that it is returning 200 OK. I can list all the languages. Same what we did in the browser, sending a GET request on the root resource, and we will be provided with a JSON array of language strings. We can verify this here. So this is in once again behind the scenes using the Citrus JSON validator to validate payloads. Once again, this is pretty powerful. So ordering of fields is not important in JSON, and it's supported here. We can make use of ignore expressions. So maybe there's a timestamp in the JSON message. We cannot really expect this timestamp, so we can ignore it, or we can validate the timestamp that it has a certain date format and all that stuff. So here it's pretty easy. We just expect the arrays of languages here and say it's 200 OK. Then we want to add a greeting. We send a put request on a slash India for the new language. And we say Namaste ApacheCon. And we want to receive a 201 created. And then we get this new language with a get request. And we want to receive this from the service with 200 OK. Then we delete this very same language once again, And then we have also in error scenario where we get a language which is obviously not available on the service, and we want to validate the 404 not found. So let's simply run this test. It is located as a feature file in this test subdirectory. So I can say yux test, use the test directory, and it's called greeting service test or service feature. And once I execute this, this is then uploaded to the as a custom resource to the operator, and the operator will take care of preparing the runtime, execute this test inside the cluster, so that the service is ready to be called by the test, and the responses are validated. So it's pretty simple, and hopefully we will have a green test at the very end. Yeah, that was successful. So we executed a total of 6 tests, all these tests that we have seen here. And in the logging, I enabled the debug logging. So we have a little bit of information here. You can see that a lot of things are going in behind. So all this JSON validation stuff. So maybe let's let a test fail. So what can I do? I can just say here, we want the wait to return 404, which is obviously not the case. So then we should have a failing test. So this is a But the good thing is here, I can also use the OC command line tool or the kube control command line tool to see the tests. Right now, the logging output here was not as expected. So the log streaming just broke up. I had this several times today. Don't know exactly what is the case here, but the test is running right now. It was before it was completed. And if I once again see this, I see the test is failing as expected, because I said here the health check did not return the status 404. So this was obviously my test to see a failing test. But later on, we can also have another example for a failing test. But I want to show you the test command and the test custom resource reflects the status of the test results. So if I have a passed test, this phase of the custom resource will be passed. If I have a failing test, then the custom resource and the underlying pod will be in the status of failed, and I will be provided with error messages that comes directly from the test, saying what was wrong, what which check in the JSON validation, for example, was failing. So this is a good example for me to have a look at running tests. We can also maybe have a look into the OpenShift world and see in the workloads that there is this pod in here. It's in the error state, because it was failing. And if I go in here, I see here that there are some config maps attached to it. I can see that this is my test that I was providing into the custom resource as a feature file. I can see this here. And I can see also the outcome and the error messages of this test in the logs, of course, and also in the status update. So here we can also have the error message in the logs, like in here, fails was the health check was failing, and it was not expecting the 404, or the service returned not the 404. Okay, so let's move on. I said we want to also test a little bit event streaming with Kafka. So here's the greeting splitter. This is receiving messages from a Kafka topic greetings, and it's extracting the message from the JSON body, and it's splitting the message by spaces into its words, and then sends it to the Kafka topic words. So let's simply say camel run, camel k greeting splitter, and here in the topology view, it should soon pop up. Here it is, the greeting splitter. This is a second camel k integration, and I have this Streamsy Kafka cluster, for example, running here, and I should be able to provide a post request on this greeting service, and then the post request sends the message to the greeting topic, and the splitter takes over and splits it into its own words, and should be able to receive the splitted words then. So let's have a look at this split event feature. So right now I'm doing exactly this. I'm sending the post request to trigger a new event on the greeting service. And at the very end, I want to receive two messages in here saying hello and ApacheCon. I had a little bit of trouble because of the ordering of messages. So I was using here an assertion on the message body because I really didn't manage to get the topic in the right order. So sometimes the message hello was the first one, and sometimes the message ApacheCon was the first one that I received. So then I, as a quick fix in here, I said, okay, I assert that the message is any of hello or ApacheCon, which demonstrates a little bit of the Citrus power behind. So in Citrus, you can use these so-called validation matchers in order to validate the plain text body, which is plain text in here, to be any of hello or ApacheCon. And I do this twice because I want to receive two messages from the words topic. So let's just demonstrate this. Yux test. This is called greeting split. Hopefully this is working because I have to restart the Kafka cluster right before the presentation. So crossing fingers for the demo gods, if there are any. And see if this is running through. And this is a way of testing multiple CamelK integrations at the same time with this feature file. And yeah, I'm happy this has passed. So we have a successful test in here. Cool. So this was a good way to test also multiple integrations within one test. Of course, I could also split this up and have a test that pushes messages to the greeting event topic and just validating that the splitter is working directly. And I can really have a powerful way of testing in here. Also, what I wanted to show in here is I am using Humcrest matchers in here, and this is not part of the initial Yux runtime, but you can add additional artifacts coming from Maven Central or from a JITpack repository or from a Minio repository that is running in the cluster. You can add additional artifacts also with your own custom custom steps that you implemented in behavior-driven development to integrate these custom steps into the feature in here. So I added this Citrus validation Humcrest module, which is not part of the out-of-the-box feature set in Yux, and I can use this then because I just added this as a additional requirement. So one thing that I also wanted to show you is the tool support. So I can jump into, or I have syntax highlighting in here, which is also very, very cool. So the Cucumber extension here, it is in IntelliJ. It knows all the words and all the out of the box features that, that we have in here. So if I go on and say given variable, then it knows what you can do. You can have multiple variables. You can have one variable. This is a Yux feature in here. So it really has this auto-completion and the syntax highlighting, which is really, really cool. And you can also jump into the implementation. So if I jump into this here, I can see the Java code that is behind this line. And I, as you can see, we jump into a Yux HTTP module in here, which provides this kind of step. So this is also really, really cool. So let's have a look at the, we're almost out of time. I wanted to show you one more thing in here, which is really, really cool, is the way to have examples and to drive your feature file with examples. So I have this, get request, and I use a scenario outline instead of a scenario, and I use placeholders in my feature sentences, and at the very bottom I can use examples for these. And what Cucumber is doing, it for each example that is giving in here, it executes the above scenario. So if I run this test in here, we can just do it out of for fun. If I say Yux test test scenario outline, I think greeting outline feature, then this will be executing this scenario three times with this given examples. And yeah, this is pretty much what I wanted to show you as a demo. So let's briefly look into the onto the clock. Yeah, we have like 1 minute or 2 minutes left. So really, really cool to see that this is all working with the Cucumber out of the box features, with the Citrus out of the box features, and combining all this behavior driven development into executing this on a Kubernetes cluster. So let me just go back to my presentation and finish this up with a last word into the future. So there's a good way to get involved. So this, maybe this is the most important thing here. Please get involved. Say us what you give us feedback. Get involved. Have a look at the open issues, or just test it and use it. And this is the right time, because we are at the very beginning with this. And this is maybe what I want to close here, and maybe give 2 minutes or so for questions. Maria or Soren, how is the clock?
Hi. So we have some questions here. For example, Hemang Ajmera, I don't know how to pronounce that. I think your services are running on the same cluster as in KubeMetas Jax, but want to confirm there is no such dependency. I mean, Jax can be used to test any service running on any platform as long as it can be connected, right?
Right. So you don't have to run Jax and your system under test in the same namespace. No, you don't have to do that. That's a question.
Christina Lin asked if we can configure the given somewhere outside the code. That's a good one.
Somewhere outside the code. I don't know if I get this right. So do you mean that you have custom steps?
In the properties.
In the properties. Yes. Yes, of course. Yeah. So I had this connection properties all in the feature file itself, but of course, yeah, you can use the property files and externalize this. I also believe this is not happening right now, but we should be using config maps too and secrets to have this passwords and connection data. Yeah, it's a good one. Thanks.
And Aurelien, of course, is asking if you have tried to configure other IDEs like VS Code and how to configure IntelliJ IDEA to know all the JAXA specific code to provide completion, hopper, and everything.
Yeah, that's a good question. So this is all making use of the default Cucumber in the IDEs extensions for VS Code, Eclipse, IntelliJ, and so on that know how to deal with these feature files and how to deal with Cucumber in the in behind. So you should have all this syntax highlighting and auto completion available. You have to add this to your class path in the project. So I can show you this quickly. Here in my little example, I have a Maven POM file where I add all the YUX modules in order to have those on the class path. And once they are on the class path, then the extensions of the IDE is able to have syntax highlighting and to have to jump into the steps and so on. So you have to bring it on the class path somehow.
The next session already started, so if there are no more questions, I think we can move on to the other room. Thank you, Christoph. It has been really interesting.
Thank you.
See you on the other session.
See you. See you. Bye.